Welcome to the A4 Podcast. This is episode 59. You know, I only seem to get sick on the weekdays. I must have a weekend immune system. Okay, so that was obviously a fabrication. just some video editing magic. But I did appear on episode 59 of the A4 Podcast with Jabbo, Joey, and Earl. It was an absolute blast. I got to sit there and talk all night long. So when that does release, I will link it in the description for anybody watching in the future. Today's video, we've got a haul, we've got some eBay stuff, some BrickLink stuff, and I will tease some upcoming projects that this stuff is for. So let's get started. Okay, so we'll start with this one from eBay. I'm pretty sure I know what this is. I've been trying to put like sticky notes on everything I get because these boxes have been in a stack for a little while. Let's see. Well, it's packaged fairly well. And you can already see what it is. This is the 40-year anniversary, I guess, of something. You never know with Lego with these anniversaries. let me get this opened up here. I'm not sure exactly when this set came out. It wasn't... I've seen it around, so it may have come out during a dim age of mine. Let's set this over here. So there it is. The box is in great condition. And yeah, okay. So it's even, it's all bagged up. And he says, thanks. So that's pretty cool. I'm not sure if I'm just going to display it or maybe try to motorize it somehow or I don't know. So that's just a fun little item I picked up. This is from BrickLink. Yeah, okay. So this is just a few things. I ordered a bunch of 2x4 used bricks in white because they were very cheap. These aren't in the greatest of condition. I didn't expect them to be, especially them being white, but they'll be used on the interior of mills plates and things like that. That's kind of what I've been using, so I was not worried about these being in super great condition. That's actually, I'm using a lot of my bricks that are in rough condition for that kind of thing. And this Bug and Bear is the seller. This is, I think, my second order with them. I've never had any issues. This is why I placed the order. This is four of the pole reverser 9-volt switches. These can go for a fair amount. I think I paid, it was under $4 each for these. So that's why I went ahead and picked up four. I think these are really going to come in handy for some future projects. So I made sure to get them. I got some more gears. These are in blue because I just thought that was really cool. I'd like to incorporate that somehow. This is the bottom of the micro motor. I pick up these whenever I see a fair price on them. It's the top part that's definitely the most expensive out of the two. Then I got some more of these numbered tiles. They just had the number two on them, so I got three of them from them. And this little, I don't know, porthole piece. I'm always interested in underwater things, so I try to pick those up as we go. This is another one from eBay. It is Lego related, but it is not actually Lego. You might be able to tell by the shape of it. I hope I didn't hurt it, did I? Okay, this is probably the worst possible way to open a package like this, but here we are. That's what we do here. Alright, so this is the Lego Technic Idea Book, Fantastic Contraptions, by this person. I'm not going to try to pronounce that. I picked this up on a recommendation from my friend. He has a YouTube channel, Gears and Bricks, and he's got some pretty cool projects that he's working on, some like long-term. It's a big project, like... but it's pretty cool to see how he solved some of the issues so far. So I'm anxious to see how it ends up coming together. So thanks for the recommendation. I'll be flipping through this and see what see if I can pick up any tips. Okay, this is the main one that I wanted today. It actually came a day early, so I'm pretty stoked about that. I was hoping I wouldn't have to record this video tomorrow. That's the thing, when you're doing haul videos, you got to film opening it, and so you can't use it until you until you get the video out. All right, a bunch more 2x4 white. I believe these are new. I think all of this is new, if I remember correctly. A bunch of 2x4 white, a bunch more 2x4 in yellow, and a bunch more 2x4 in black. And these are going to be used for, it's kind of a mills plate thing. It's going to be some type of GBC machine. I hesitate to call it a module because it's not going to link up with other modules. It's just going to be a standalone marble machine kind of thing. Kind of like I built years ago, my personal YouTube channel. Those videos are rough, but I went back and watched them. And I was like, you know, there was some kind of cool things in there. I definitely had some interesting pneumatic features and things like that. So that's going to be a fun project, and hopefully I get that one done timely manner. Some 2x4 blade I needed. I couldn't find some of these the other day. I was like, all right, let me throw a few in there on the on the order. More 1x2 trans clear red. These go on the 9-volt lights, of course, because they don't have the tube inside. And just a bunch of plates. So I got some 2x16 blay, some 6x16 blay, and a bunch of 8x8 blay. Whenever these are in the pick-a-brick, I try to get as many as I possibly can, because if you can fit like 16 of these in a pick-a-brick cup, you're breaking even like already. These were, I want to say, $1.25 to $1.50 each, something like that. And it was one of the cheapest sellers on there that had a good quantity. So I bought, I think, 50 of them. but, you know, these are just so handy. So I try to pick these up whenever I can. And they're definitely going to be used in that project. Oh, yeah. So, yeah, he had the yellow and green, too, for the trans clear pieces for the 9-volt lamps. And I got... I couldn't believe how cheap these were. 200 of in black and yellow. These are the 1x2 cheese wedge pieces. These are used a lot in GBC. You just kind of put them facing, you know, you just kind of make a little channel for the ball to roll along. So these will definitely come in handy. And that's kind of the, I'm going for an industrial kind of look. So kind of blay for a lot of it, but then accenting with black and yellow. And I'll have some other colors too, but you know, the black and yellow alternating just kind of gives that industrial kind of vibe. So I'm really excited about that project. I feel a little stuck with a couple things, but I have some really cool ideas. It'll probably take a while to get it all going, but I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed this haul, and like I said, be sure to subscribe to Brick Chains and watch the A-Full podcast whenever it comes out every 2 weeks. I look forward to it every single time. It's one of my favorite podcasts or shows on YouTube, so be sure to check it out. Thanks for watching, and remember to play well. Okay, so that was obviously a fabricate. What? Welcome to the A-Fool podcast. This is episode 59. I already forgot it. Welcome to the A-Fool podcast. This is episode 59. You know, I only seem to get sick on the weekends. Oh, shit.